Don't look at the rocket. Look at the people. Impossibly tiny next to NASA's new behemoth, they tell you how big it is. The SLS, or Space Launch System, is leaving its factory in Louisiana, the $15 billion centerpiece of an effort to go back to the moon to stay, to live.
We are achieving sustainability with commercial and international partners, and of course, the most powerful rocket ever built in human history, the SLS.
21 stories tall and as big around as a 747, the rocket may remind some Central Floridians of a space shuttle external fuel tank. And it's much the same thing, built in the same factory, with four modified space shuttle rocket engines attached. It's been tested to the bursting point. On its flights to the moon, the SLS will have two booster rockets, much like the shuttles, but bigger, along with a second stage and an Apollo-style spaceship for the astronauts. The moon landing is in less than 5 years, if Congress puts up the money.
It's apolitical, it's bipartisan. Members of Congress on both sides of the aisle want to see the first woman on the moon. We have an ability to achieve that now.
The rocket's first stop is at a testing center in Mississippi for what will be a mind-blowing, ear-splitting test firing of its rocket engines. So it'll be a few months before the rocket arrives here at KSC. It'll then be launched on an unpiloted test flight to the moon. And that was originally scheduled in 2017 and now is not expected until early 2021. We're live at the Kennedy Space Center. Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.